There is some really good news on the coronavirus front this morning. According to new data from the federal government, new cases of coronavirus in nursing homes across the country fell nearly 90% in 8 weeks, from over 33,000 new cases during the December peak to just over 3,500 the week of February 14th. Now remember, more than 170,000 people in long-term care facilities have died of COVID-19, which accounts for more than a third of all coronavirus deaths in the United States. So this news is so welcomed today. Joining me now is Mark Parkinson, the president and CEO of the American Healthcare Association, which represents over 14,000 long-term care facilities across the country. Mark, I've been thinking, I mean, you and I have been talking since the very first days, the first month of the pandemic, and this is the first time that this is all good news all around. New infections dropping nearly 90%.
Yeah, it's absolutely astonishing, and I can't tell you how happy we are about it. You nailed the numbers. A peak of 30,000 cases a week just 3 months ago, now 3,000 new cases a week, a 90% drop. And I'll tell you, Kate, that data is about 2 weeks old. As I talk to providers around the country this week, they are telling me that they have zero cases. It's just absolutely astonishing. We all thought that the vaccine would reduce cases. I don't think any of us thought that we would have zero cases. But that's the case in almost all the nursing homes and assisted living buildings across the country. It's amazing and fantastic.
And Mark, is that what you attribute it to? Is this the effect of the vaccine?
Yeah, absolutely. So two things have happened. One is that the governors did a really good job at prioritizing long-term care and getting clinics into the buildings. So CVS and Walgreens and some long-term care facilities have come into every building and provided the vaccine. So the first thing is that program worked. The second thing that I don't think we anticipated was the vaccine worked astonishingly well. It's hard to put into words how well this vaccine works. There were very few side effects with these shots, and the results speak for themselves. In most facilities right now, absolutely no COVID.
One thing I remember seeing, though, there was quite a bit of reporting that the employees at facilities were turning down the shot. I think Walgreens had said in January that at some facilities it was as high as 80% declining of staffers declining to get the shot. Is that still an issue?
It is. That's been the one negative thing about the entire program. You know, we had really good uptake from the residents. 80 to 90% of the residents said yes and took the vaccine. Unfortunately, with staff, we're only at about 40% right now. So we have set as a sector-wide goal to get that percentage up to 75% by June 30th, and we're implementing all sorts of programs to do so. The problem is there's just a lot of misinformation out there about this vaccine. The side effects were thought that they would be much greater than they are, and then all sorts of other crazy rumors out there. As we're able to beat those down, we think we're going to be able to get the staff vaccination rates up. But even without that high level, we're still seeing no cases in the facility. So I think we have some level of herd immunity, even at the numbers that we have right now.
I mean, Mark, and for everybody, I know that people will know who's watched the show, you're not one to be overly optimistic because you were extremely realistic about what you were up against in the beginning. So hearing you say this is really heartwarming. So then you also have, you know, more and more people inside facilities and outside facilities being fully vaccinated. And we're waiting for the CDC to kind of give their guidance of what fully vaccinated people can do. Do you think that this means that it's time to start loosening restrictions at nursing homes on things like visitors?
It is. We need two things right now. First of all, we need for the priority for the vaccination for the nursing homes to continue. So now that we're done with the clinics, the White House needs to set aside some doses for new residents and new staff. The second thing is, and this is really great, we need to reopen these nursing homes. These residents haven't been around their loved ones now for almost a year. It's been incredibly difficult on them and their loved ones. Now that we've reached this level of success, we really think it's time to open the buildings up.
It's so great to hear that, Mark. I mean, like, are you looking at hope on the horizon at this point?
Absolutely. I mean, I think that we have the clinical nightmare in nursing homes behind us. And now we can really get to recovering from the emotional side that the residents and the staff and the incredible trauma that they've gone through. But if we just continue to stay vigilant with this program, all of the horrible stats on cases and deaths in nursing homes, those are over. Those are history.
Yeah. Thank you so much for coming on, Mark.
You bet. Absolutely. Thank you.